this before the end of our project next year in the final conference. I wish you total success today in the exchange of our ideas, and I hope you will identify good suggestions for your future investments. Now I pass the floor to Alessia, representative of lead partners of our project. Please, Alessia.
Yes, thank you very much, Tibi and Florin. Thank you, everybody, for intervening for this important exchange of experience. It's our fourth exchange of experience and our very competent partner, Alea, as in charge of organizing it now. So on behalf of Region Friuli Venezia Giulia, as a lead partner, I thank you again, Alea, and welcome you. Also on behalf of Mr. Sebastiano Cacciaguerra and Dr. Gianni Mighetti and Dr. Canali, who are the head of unit of the energy unit and the vice director and director, central director of the sustainable development directorate of our region. Okay. Okay, so as you all know, since you are very already in depth involved since 1 year and a half in the project, not 2 years already, almost, it's exactly 2 years because we started with a kickoff meeting in October 2019 and we managed, despite this pandemic situation, to keep on with our activities. We are concentrated on the priority improving low carbon economy policies. And as a consortium, we can we have at our disposal a total budget of 1,500,000, a bit more overall budget. And the duration is till July 2023. Of course, there was the preparatory action with activities that will include it starting from August 2019. As you know, we have nine partners involved from five EU countries. You can see them listed. And the project is divided into two phases. The focus and the objectives of the project, your stakeholders have already participated, and thank you again for joining to the previous exchange of experiences in Spain and Finland. And in Italy, in Friuli Venezia Giulia in June. So you already know very well the project. At the status at present, we have on the basis of a total project deliverables, you can see the updated situation, which is proceeding quite well in line with GIS and application form objectives and commitments. So the regional stakeholders meetings are 18. We are the communication strategy is proceeding well. The exchange of experiences as the present one, of course. and to paired with steering group meetings, what we do at the end always of the project partner meetings. We have done already 3 campus technical meetings in order to draft campus technical solutions that can be shared among the partners and improved thanks to the projects already realized in each country. In order to this, to attain these objectives, we also have we are in drafting a catalog of good practice that is also in line with the objectives. Now the great goal is to pass from the identification of the strengths and weaknesses in the policy adopted by each country. We made a survey in order to identify the technical and financial performances applied in each university. So combining the technical innovative solution already applied in each campus, paired with the policy framework and policy instrument developed that we will develop during the innovate during the project. Which is the goal and the task of the regional bodies. So thanks to this, we want to identify the good practices that we saw in the slide before, the catalog that we are implementing, and this in order to make measurable the results that are part of a specific objective. But as we did a further step in order to pass from the innovation solutions, the results that we want to obtain, we have made a further step in order to try to identify on the basis of the European Union regulations the smart readiness indicators methodology, which is based on 8 criteria, which deal not only with energy and especially what we are more developing, which is smart grids, self-generation, and the use of renewable energies. But also health and well-being and information to the occupant, because the smart readiness indicators are the basis on which we can measure and understand if we are able to raise awareness if we are able to raise awareness of the benefits of smart buildings, in particular from the energy perspective view, and above all, stimulate investment. So this is a very challenging goal that we have to identify how to find public-private financing methods and tools that can be common among the partners, even if, of course, every single country has got legal, different legal contexts and different financial systems. But since we are part of member states of the European Union, and we are we have to improve interregional cooperation, which is the main objective of Interreg Europe, we have to put in common the actual different regional legal systems and investment facilities in order to support efficiency, smart efficiency in buildings. So smart technology, of course, and enhance synergies between energy buildings and other policy segments, as well as the integration of buildings sectors into future energy systems and markets. So, in order to resume this, the impact scores of smart ready services, the targets are energy savings on site, flexibility for the grid and storage, but also comfort, as we were seeing in the image before. Comfort in response to the needs of the occupant. Thanks to this analysis that each country has done and that we put in common, really with specific data and numbers, the next step would be to define five action plans to be ready by April 2022, which will be produced by each region in order to put really to show the process that we have learned. Process of cross-sectoral innovation and cooperation, and to specify how the action can be implemented, thanks to the important and fundamental role of the stakeholders that must be always side by side with the universities, in order to give them the practical feedback and the most innovative solutions update. These action plans will, as you can see, transform learnings and what we exchange during the present, for example, exchange of experience, transform them into concrete action, which is what the project wants to attain, in order to pass from the phase one, which is the construction phase, to the practical experience and to the use of the funds at disposal of the partners, because in phase two the goal is to use the project partners own funds, thanks to structural funds, and also, as in the case of Italy, the funds put at disposal, we have a national plan for resilience and restart, thanks to the post-pandemic European Union allocation. And in fact, our region is concentrated on the measure number two of the plan for recovery and resilience, which is really dedicating to ecological transition. We have a new ministry since some months, which will really try to enhance all the subjects of sustainability, mobility, electric mobility, energy efficiency of buildings, which are really the topic of our project. So there is a synergy, a complete synergy with our Italian central government. Already they are in line with the President Ursula von der Leyen. As you know, there were very tight contacts and the reunion. On Friday, from Friday to Sunday, there will be the 20 ministry, prime ministers reunion in Rome in order to continue on the path of post-pandemic crisis in order to face and to decide properly how to use the funds allocated, which is the first big action after the Second World War. And so Italy, I hope, will do its best and will obtain the good results to change our country in a green optic. We are a bit in delay compared to our partners as Finland, Spain, Romania, especially Finland. We start from a lower level as Italy, but we have very good excellencies all over the country. And so with Draghi, Mr. Draghi, our prime minister, we have this great honor to have him as prime minister. I'm sure that we will be at the height of the commitments, of the European Commission commitments, and the faith, that the trust that they have in us. So please, now, thanks to this first introduction, which I just repeated what you already knew, we can pass by and continue the meeting, please. Thank you, Florin.
Thank you.
Because thank you. Our action plan also will be discussed more in depth.
Okay. Thank you, Alessia. Thank you for this comprehensive description of our project. Now we can move on to the next topic in our agenda, namely the Estonia Unica activities in Romania, which will be presented by our director, Florin. But before that, I would like to mention that from now on, the presentations will be preceded by short video material, namely an interview taken with the presenters themselves, and this is because we wanted to make it this event more lively.
Agenția Locală a Energiei ALBA, ALEA, este o asociație, organizație non-profit, înființată în 2008 cu scopul de a susține dezvoltarea energetică durabilă în județul nostru, în județul ALBA. Suntem situați în municipiul ALBA Iulia și am apărut ca urmare a aplicării de către Consiliul Județean ALBA pe un proiect european în cadrul programului Intelligent Energy Europe. Scopul a fost acela de a se crea o entitate vector al sustenabilității energetice a județului nostru. În acest sens, obiectivele prioritare ale agenției au fost elaborarea unei politici energetice la nivel județean și local, creșterea gradului de informare și educație în domeniul utilizării eficiente a energiei și promovarea unor proiecte pilot de creștere a eficienței energetice și de utilizare a energiei din surse regenerabile locale. Astfel, am realizat masterplanul energetic al județului Alba, primul de acest fel în România, instrument programatic de fundamentare a politicilor energetice locale. Din anul 2017, în baza acestui document, inițial a fost elaborată strategia energetică, document asumat public drept cadrul strategic pentru dezvoltarea energetică durabilă a județului nostru. ALEA a coordonat realizarea și a susținut implementarea planurilor de acțiune pentru energie durabilă pentru peste 20 de autorități locale din regiunea noastră, dar și din întreaga țară. De asemenea, am fost implicați în realizarea a peste 10 programe pentru îmbunătățirea eficienței energetice, documente de planificare obligatorii pentru autoritățile locale cu peste 5.000 de locuitori în baza legii eficienței energetice. În acest sens, agenția noastră a devenit furnizor atestat de servicii de management energetic. Am susținut dezvoltarea unor planuri de mobilitate urbană durabilă în municipii importante din România și am elaborat primele 4 planuri de acțiune pentru e-mobilitate din țara noastră. O preocupare constantă de-a lungul anilor a fost dezvoltarea și menținerea unei colaborări strânse cu primării din regiune, mai ales cu cele din județul Alba, cărora le oferim în mod constant consultanță în materie de management energetic. Prin calitatea ALEA de suport recunoscut la nivelul Comisiei Europene al inițiativei Convenției Primarilor, am promovat activ inițiativa în România și am oferit sprijin tehnic complet autorităților locale semnatare, inclusiv în realizarea unor planuri de adaptare la schimbările climatice. Pentru susținerea tehnică a semnatarelor convenției, am creat în cadrul agenției noastre Observatorul Energetic Regional ANERGO, care furnizează gratuit municipalităților partenere servicii complete de culegere, prelucrare și analiza datelor energetice, indispensabile elaborării și monitorizării implementării planurilor de acțiune pentru energie durabilă și climă. Dezvoltând parteneriate solide la nivel european, în acest sens putem aminti că ALEA este membru activ al FEDARENE și al Energy Watch, agenția noastră a fost și este implicată cu rezultate notabile ca partener pentru România în proiecte europene, 13 până în prezent, proiecte dedicate unor domenii de interes ca eficiența energetică în clădiri, crearea unor comunități energetice locale, achiziții publice verzi, mobilitatea urbană durabilă și promovarea e-mobilității, valorificarea surselor locale de energie regenerabilă, susținerea planificării energetice locale și multe altele. Proiectul Estrei Unica reprezintă pentru noi o oportunitate importantă în implicarea activă a agenției noastre în susținerea cercetării inovării în domeniul energiei durabile și în colaborarea cu universități tehnice din România, dar și din țările partenerilor din consorțiul Estrei Unica. Având ca scop promovarea unor proiecte de energie durabilă în cadrul unor clădiri din campusurile universitare, prin soluții inovative identificate și implementate de către universități, proiectul se bazează pe un aprofundat schimb de interregional de experiență. Dorim ca prin acest transfer de competențe și know-how să susținem universitățile din țară, principale organizații cu potențial de cercetare și inovare, în realizarea unor soluții inovative și în identificarea surselor de finanțare adecvate pentru implementarea acestora.
Okay. Thank you, TB. I will continue with some reasons, some conclusion from our country related to the S3 UNICA development in our country. Surely I pass after this presentation because it was before better. As you know from Alessia's presentation, the main objective of our project is to improve regional policies by implementing the cycle of energy efficiency innovation in university campus buildings, surely from invention through market testing to expansion, and to improve regional and interregional ecosystems related to this sector of energy. In our country, S3 UNICA specifically aims to improve the targeted regional policy. We discuss after that about this, to increase capacity of Romanian universities in improving energy efficiency in their campus buildings based on experience exchange and know-how sharing. Our identified policy instrument to be supported initial was regional operational program for the previous period, but current we commute to as a policy instrument, namely the regional development plan of central region for the ongoing period. A reason for this replacement was the constatation that the initial policy instrument was closed for application of new projects, and in this previous policy a lot of projects coming from universities for EE domain was not allowed. Also, we will target in this project the new regional operation program for this ongoing period, and we'll do this because this regional operation program is an important financing instrument for energy efficiency works in public building. About our main stakeholders, we succeeded to involve a lot of universities, strong universities from our region, but not only. We mentioned several of them. 1st December 1918, University of Alba Iulia, Lucian Blaga University of Sibiu, Technical University of Cluj-Napoca, Transylvania University of Brașov, Valahian University of Târgoviște, Vasile Alexandrii University of Bacău. Also, we have strong partners, stakeholders from regional and local level, as the Regional Development Agency Centru, responsible for this regional development program and management authority for this next regional operation program, but also Alba County Council and several important municipalities from Central Development Region. We understand quickly the situation in energy efficiency level in our domain and in university campus university buildings. We identified that the levels of energy efficiency are low because a lot of university until now don't have possibility to invest in such kind of works, and they need a lot to finance this kind of activities. Even if action plans in this matter are elaborated by university, mainly by the lack of funds, difficulty remain a major, and it's important to try to overcome this. And also it's important the need to diversify funding sources for energy efficiency works. We can say there are few universities until now that have benefited from financing opportunities. By example, EEA Norway funds, and they succeeded to develop their campuses implementing energy efficiency and renewable solution, energy efficient, renewable energy in their buildings. Most of Romanian universities, however, could not implement such energy efficiency works. They focused until now on the other main priorities as development of their own operating capacity, extending faculties and other. Main activities and results until now. As national partner, ALEA succeeded to determine and ensure the involvement of main stakeholders in the project, public authorities and universities. Also, we organized the regular stakeholders, regional stakeholders meetings, until now, 4. We participated in all exchange of experience and campus technical meetings as a strong event where we can identify good ideas and share experiences. We collected several best practices and uploaded until now two of them on project website. Also, we offered input for this smart readiness indicator development. Also, one stakeholder from our region, Valahia University Târgoviște, participated in development and of methodology and was a pilot applying this methodology until now. Also, we have a good results in disseminating of the project and its results in local and regional media as well on a social platform. Here we present the main activity of our stakeholders, also very important to remark that they jointly with us will formulate and already formulated proposals for the improvement of the initial policy instrument. What will be done in the future? The next strong activity is related to developing of action plan. The elaboration of this action plan will be done with close cooperation with university stakeholders and will elaborate this action plan based on the input and conclusions stemmed from interregional and regional experience exchange. Also, we have and we'll have meetings with regional development agencies Centru, the responsible body for policy instrument, and some measures were already outlined to be included in the action plan. But we think we need support from an external service provider with expertise in this field, probably between university in this elaboration process of the action plan. And finally, as expected impact and results, we have in mind by implementing the S3 UNICA and the action plan. We hope that the energy efficiency situation, energy sustainability of public buildings from university campuses will be improved in a consistent manner, our goal being to reach the status of nearly zero energy building.
Agenția pentru Dezvoltare Regională Centru este o organizație neguvernamentală de utilitate publică, a cărei menire este de a implementa politicile de dezvoltare regională în Regiunea de Dezvoltare Centru. Regiunea de Dezvoltare Centru, formată prin asocierea voluntară a celor 6 județe situate în centrul țării, respectiv Alba, Brașov, Covasna, Arghita, Mureș și Sibiu, are acum o populație de peste 2,3 milioane de locuitori și un produs intern brut per locuitor de aproape 70% din media Uniunii Europene. De 23 de ani, ADR Centru și-a dedicat activitatea susținerii principiilor care stau la baza dezvoltării regionale, reducerea disparităților inter- și intraregionale, dezvoltarea armonioasă și durabilă a regiunii. Viziunea de dezvoltare a regiunii centru pentru următorii ani are ca puncte centrale inovarea, competitivitatea, sustenabilitatea și grija pentru mediu. Aceste preocupări se regăsesc în toate programele pe care le-am derulat până în prezent în calitate de organism intermediar. Vom avea aceeași grijă pentru viitor și în programul operațional regional al regiunii centru, pe care îl vom gestiona în perioada 2021-2027 din postura de autoritate de management. O parte însemnată a finanțării din viitorul program operațional regional, adică peste 30%, vor merge către investiții cu puternică componentă de atenuare a schimbărilor climatice. Vorbind de îmbunătățirea eficienței energetice pentru clădirile publice și rezidențiale, de investiții în mobilitate urbană durabilă, de realizarea unor infrastructuri verzi în zonele urbane și un amplu proces de regenerare urbană. Vom susține și investiții în retehnologizarea companiilor pentru accelerarea adoptării tehnologiilor inovatoare, eficiente din punct de vedere energetic. Avem în regiune infrastructuri de cercetare specializate în tehnologii și soluții de eficiență energetică și suntem convinși că rolul universităților este foarte important în cercetarea și găsirea de soluții și tehnologii aplicate nevoilor comunităților noastre. Proiectul S3 Unica ne-a dat ocazia să ne implicăm și totodată să învățăm alături de partenerii de la Agenția Locală a Energiei Alba și de ceilalți parteneri ai proiectului care sunt instrumentele și politicile cele mai potrivite care să susțină implicarea universităților în dezvoltarea sustenabilă și descoperirea de soluții inteligente pentru eficiența energetică.
Okay, now we'll give the floor to the Regional Development Agency Trento.
Hello, my name is Gabriela Ciro and I'm representing the Regional Development Agency Trento. I'm the head of the cooperation unit and thank you for having us today. I hope you can see my presentation and you can hear me. Can you confirm?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So what I would like to present you today is a little bit about the regional policies and dedicated to energy efficiency and how we try by the help of the projects that we implement with our stakeholders and by ourselves to improve these policies. Okay, so you've already heard in the video presented by our general manager, Mr. Simeon Crețu, about the regional development, the region, Centru region. We are a region located in the middle of Romania. We have 6 counties and quite large. We have almost 2.3 million inhabitants. One of the figures that I would like to mention is that we have a ethnic and linguistic diversity, which almost 60% of almost 60% of the people who live in the central region are Romanians, and the others are Hungarians, Roma, and Germans. So we have many languages here. The urbanization rate is quite high. It's higher than 50%. And if we talk about the inhabitants of these municipalities, only one exceeds 2,000 inhabitants, and most of them are small towns, less than 10,000 inhabitants. Here you see a map of the urban network in Gentoo region, and you can see that we are crossed by the four pan-European transport corridors, so we are connected with all of Europe. If we talk about tourism, an asset, very important asset of our region is the rich built heritage and also the natural resources. And I would like to highlight that almost 50% of our region is covered by Natura 2000 sites. So please come and visit our region because we are very beautiful and you will have lots of things to see. So about the Regional Development Agency, as mentioned before by Mr. Andronescu, but also by our general manager, we were established in 1998. We are the only and the sole Regional Development Agency in Gentoo region. We cover the six counties of our region and we act as a regional, as an engine for the regional development. We have more than 130 employees, and our headquarters is in Alba Iulia. You all already saw the video with our headquarters. About the territorial bodies for the regional development, I would like to mention that we have a regional development board who verifies and approves the regional development plan, the policy instrument tackled by ESREI UNICA project, who approves the financial allocation for the regional development, who coordinates our activities and also endorses the agreements of the regional development concluded by our organization and other parts. This regional development board consists of 24 members. We have four seats in each county. And if we talk about the responsibilities that we have, besides the regional planning and programming, where we are the sole responsible organization for the regional development plan and the smart specialization strategy, we also are responsible for implementation of various programs. And we also are involved in cooperation projects with acting as stakeholder as for this project, but also as partner. We have 36 projects implemented by ourselves as partner, transnational, interregional projects, and we have partners all over Europe, more than almost 200 partners.
Sorry for this interruption. I believe there is a technical problem because we see indeed your presentation, but we are stuck in the first slide, which is not in a full screen.
Okay.
Let's see if it's okay. Yeah, now it has moved on to the fifth slide.
Okay, then I'll use it like this, right?
Okay, do it like that. Let's see if it's moving between six and
now?
Five. Yeah, okay, very good, thank you.
Perfect. Perfect. So, I already said what was important, and I would like to present some of the results that we have in terms of acting as intermediate body, because as you heard in the video presented by Mr. Simeon Crețu, we will act as managing authority for the regional operational program 2021-2027. So, as intermediate body, we were involved in the pre-accession funds also for the regional operational program 2007-2013 and 2014-2020. And also we acted as intermediate body for the competitiveness program for Axis 1. What I would like to highlight also is the fact that both in the regional programs, in both programming period, almost 36% of the budget was dedicated to projects involving green components. And here we speak about energy efficiency, rehabilitation of industrial polluted sites, public lighting, also bicycle lanes, But and this budget and this percentage increased in the following period, as you can see here, almost 43% of the projects had the green components. The regional operational programs 2007, 2013, and 2014, 2020, in terms of energy efficiency, the subject that we are talking today, here you have some figures. If in the first programming period we had 13 projects implemented, and just for residential public residential buildings, only 3,687 apartments were rehabilitated. In the following period, these numbers increased. The regional planning, because S3 Unica is tackling the regional development plan, I'd like to mention a little bit about this document. As I've told you before, we act as we are responsible for regional planning policies, but our principle is partnership. We have partners and we have committees, and we work in with our partners in developing and in drafting these policy documents. And our vision for 2021-2027 is to become, for the region, to become a cleaner, more attractive region for the inhabitants, but also for the tourists, with a competitive economy based on knowledge and innovation, whose each citizen will take care for preserving the good state of the environment and sustainable use of the natural resources. And to do so, we drafted this document, the Regional Development Plan, which has six strategic areas. These strategic areas are derived from the five objectives of the EU cohesion policy, which I will mention a little bit later. And here you have the fourth, environment, energy efficiency and climate change domain, which we discussed, and we had some meetings with the representatives of Alea, and it was improved due to the implementation of SUNICA at the regional level.
Universitatea Transilvania din Brașov este în prezent cea mai mare și mai performantă universitate din regiunea Centru și a șaptea universitate ca număr de studenți din România. În cele peste șapte decenii de la înființare, universitatea s-a dezvoltat continuu, având în prezent o structură comprehensivă, alcătuită din 18 facultăți, care integrează ramuri de științe inginerești, sociale, umaniste, artistice, medicale, matematice, economice, ale sportului și educației fizice. Transferul de cunoaștere se realizează prin 100 de programe de studii de licență, 74 de programe de master și prin programe de doctorat în 18 domenii. Direcțiile de cercetare prioritare al universității, definite încă din anul 2006, au ca numitor comun dezvoltarea durabilă în domenii precum eficiență energetică, economie de energie, sisteme de energie regenerabile, conservarea și utilizarea resurselor naturale, sănătate și calitatea vieții, educație, cultură, comunicare și dezvoltare economică. Universitatea Transilvania din Brașov este prima universitate din România care și-a construit propriul institut pluridisciplinar de cercetare, având ca obiectiv creșterea competitivității în cercetarea națională și internațională pentru dezvoltarea de produse sustenabile. La momentul finalizării, în 2012, Institutul de Cercetare Dezvoltare al Universității Transilvania din Brașov era cea mai mare investiție în infrastructura de cercetare pe care o universitate din România o realiza prin atragere de fonduri structurale europene pentru dezvoltarea unei comunități durabile, cu un mediu construit eficient energetic, cu energie din surse regenerabile. Institutul concentrează o infrastructură modernă și complexă de cercetare, constând din linii integrate de echipamente high-tech pentru cercetare avansată, în domeniul dezvoltării durabile. În subsidiar, dezvoltarea institutului a vizat și consolidarea legăturilor cu mediul de afaceri din regiune, prin mijlocirea transferului tehnologic și dezvoltarea cercetării aplicate, în strânsă legătură cu nevoile locale și regionale privind cercetarea, dezvoltarea, inovarea. Înființarea institutului a reprezentat o decizie strategică a universității, direcționată spre stimularea performanței în cercetare fundamentală și aplicată, bazată pe mai multe considerente: crearea unui mediu optim de studiu, cercetare, testare și experimentare, posibilitatea de concentrare a unui număr mare de echipamente tehnologice aproape de spațiile de studiu, asigurarea perspectivei de colaborare interdisciplinară prin includerea în spațiul institutului a unui număr de 30 de centre de cercetare din domenii diferite, asigurarea unui spațiu generos pentru cercetare aplicată, de natură să încurajeze relațiile de colaborare în cercetare, dezvoltare, inovare cu companiile locale prin dezvoltarea de echipe mixte. Unul dintre cele 30 de centre de cercetare din cadrul institutului este Centrul de Cercetare Sisteme de Energie Regenerabile și Reciclare, unde, într-o abordare interdisciplinară, este implementată o viziune dinamică asupra dezvoltării durabile, cu concentrarea asupra eficienței energetice și implementării sistemelor de conversie a surselor regenerabile de energie în mediul construit eficient energetic. Scopul Centrului de Cercetare Sisteme de Energie Regenerabile și Reciclare este să contribuie la dezvoltarea comunităților durabile cu soluții avansate, complexe, funcționale și fezabile, urmărind acoperirea fluxului, materiale, componente, sisteme, clădiri, comunități durabile. Un exemplu de comunitate durabilă îl constituie chiar Institutul de Cercetare Dezvoltare al Universității Transilvania din Brașov, alcătuit din 12 clădiri cu eficiență energetică ridicată, echipate cu sisteme de conversie a surselor regenerabile de energie. Pentru prepararea apei calde menajere sunt utilizate sisteme solar termice cu colectoare solar termice plan-plate și cu tuburi vidate, amplasate pe 9 din cele 12 clădiri. Necesarul de energie termică pentru încălzire în sezonul rece este asigurat pentru 2 dintre clădiri cu sisteme geotermice cu pompe de căldură de tip sol-apă prin intermediul unui schimbător de căldură geotermic vertical, alcătuit din 4 sonde geotermice cu adâncimea de 90 de metri, și unui schimbător de căldură geotermic orizontal, amplasat la adâncime de 3 metri, pe o suprafață de 1000 de metri pătrați. O parte din necesarul de energie electrică al clădirilor este asigurat de sisteme fotovoltaice cu diverse mecanisme de orientare, monoaxială și biaxială, de exemplu un sistem fotovoltaic de 12 kW-peak amplasat pe terasa laboratorului L211, un sistem fotovoltaic de 5 kW-peak amplasat pe terasa clădirii L7 și un sistem fotovoltaic alcătuit din 5 platforme, fiecare cu puterea de 2 kW-peak amplasat pe terenul de lângă clădiri. Iluminatul perimetral este asigurat pentru 2 dintre clădiri, cu sisteme eoliene prevăzute fiecare cu câte 3 turbine eoliene de mici dimensiuni și cu baterii de acumulator pentru stocarea energiei electrice produse. Proiectul S3 Unica prezintă interes pentru diseminarea soluțiilor inovative de eficiență energetică și de conversie a surselor regenerabile de energie, implementate și testate pe parcursul dezvoltării și exploatării Institutului de Cercetare Dezvoltare al Universității Transilvania din Brașov. Acest exemplu de bună practică poate contribui la îmbunătățirea ecosistemelor regionale și interregionale în sectorul eficienței energetice în clădirile din campusurile universitare. De asemenea, schimburile de experiență realizate în cadrul evenimentelor organizate prin proiectul S3 Unica, precum vizite, prezentări, ateliere de lucru și evaluări interactive, au constituit o bună oportunitate de învățare reciprocă, interregională, în domeniul specializării inteligente pentru campusuri universitare.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Macedon Moldovan, and I would like to present you today the energy efficient built environment developed in the Transylvania University of Brasov, Romania. I am an associate professor at the Faculty of Product Design and Environment. Actually, I'm now in the classroom of this faculty because I have some classes. That is why I have to wear the mask. My research activity is developed in the Renewable Energy Systems and Recycling Research Center of the Transylvania University of Brasov. Okay, we are located in the middle of Romania, in the center of Romania, in a beautiful mountain area with a lot of tourist attractions that I would like to invite you to visit. The paper is structured in four, the presentation is structured in four parts, a short introduction related to the actual problems in the built environment, followed by a presentation of two case studies related to the newly developed energy efficient built environment into the Transylvania University of Brasov, Romania. The results obtained in several research projects and related discussions. And finally, conclusions. Well, there is a big need to develop an energy efficient built environment. And this is directly related with the continuous population growth, its increased needs, among which the main ones refers the energy, food and water, and the increased building stock, while the earth resources continuously decrease. In this context, at European level, the European Green Deal was launched in December 2019 by the European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, aiming at a climate neutral Europe by 2050. Through clean, reliable and affordable energy, sustainable transport, circular economy, and just transition. Thus, in terms of renewable energy, a European strategy was developed for the period 2010-2050 with three sets of targets for 2020, 2030, and 2050. These targets are very well known. I will not insist on these targets. When we discuss about the built environment, we have to remember that the existing stock of the building consists of 98% of old buildings built before 70s with low energy efficiency, and only 2% of the buildings are new and energy efficient. The strategy is to refurbish this old building stock, aiming at a standard of low energy building, followed by the standard nearly zero energy building, and a new standard, we propose this concept of nearly zero energy communities. In this way, we want to have, we hope that we will have a sustainable built environment. The steps to be followed are pretty clear. First, the energy consumption of the building should be decreased. And these values are different for different countries in Europe. After that, renewable energy systems must be implemented to cover a very significant share of the energy demand. These shares are established in each member state and range between 25 and 50% in the selected states tabulated here. In this way, we will get a nearly zero energy building. In our renewable energy systems and recycling research center, the main research topics refer the sustainable built environment, the renewable energy systems, materials for energy and the environment, and last but not least, waste is recycling and reuse. Our focus is on the conversion of solar energy into thermal, electrical, and chemical energy, with its main subtopics presented here. Solar thermal and photovoltaic systems, their components, solar tracking systems, photoreactors, photocatalytic processes, and photocatalysts. Another topic is related to the geothermal energy conversion based on ground-coupled heat pumps with horizontal and vertical geothermal heat exchangers, and also on hybrid and energy mixes of these heat pumps and solar thermal system, biomass, photovoltaic systems. And now the case studies. Our research center is located in two sites. One, it is on the Colina Hill campus, where our Faculty of Product Design is situated. And the other site is represented by the Research and Development Institute of the Transylvania University of Brasov. On the Colina Hill, we have this solar house built in 2009, having a surface of 290 square meters and a specific energy demand of around 200 kilowatt hour per square meter per year for thermal and electrical energy. With the implemented renewable energy systems, we succeed to cover almost 83-84% of energy from renewable sources. You can see here an aerial view of the campus with a solar house in this area. And the main contributor to this high renewable energy share, 84%, it's a geothermal heat pump located in the laboratory in this building. The installed power of 10.8 kilowatt for heating, for which the electrical energy is yearly balanced. Something is wrong.
Yes, as we can see, there is a connection gap. We lost the connection with Brasov University. So, okay, now they are back.
Okay, I can hear you now.
Yes, you are back now, yes.
Okay, I think I have to stop sharing. I cannot see my screen. Let's open the tray again.
I have to say
okay, it is visible.
Yes, just now. Yeah, we are at the slide 15.
15. Okay. So the solar house located in this image, it's heated by a geothermal heat pump with a thermal power of 10.8 kilowatt, for which the electrical energy is yearly balanced by a photovoltaic platform of 10 kilowatt peak. Also, we have a solar thermal system providing domestic hot water and a small wind turbine, part of a PV wind hybrid system used to contribute to the electrical energy load. Here we can see the heat pump, the geothermal heat exchanger. We have a horizontal geothermal heat exchanger, the storage tanks for thermal energy, and the underfloor heating system. Related to the solar thermal system, we have three evacuated tube solar thermal collectors, another six evacuated tube solar thermal collectors, and the thermal energy is stored in first in a 300 liter storage tank, and after that in bigger storage tanks, 2000 liters. In terms of photovoltaic systems, we have a fixed photovoltaic system with an installed power of 10 kilowatts. A tracker with an installed power of 1.5 kilowatt, and also some demonstrators developed by PhD students with trackers for PV modules. So these demonstrators are installed only for one module just to demonstrate their capacity. Okay. In the second case study, the energy efficient built environment from the Research and Development Institute, built in 2012, it's presented. Here, the energy efficiency implemented solution, the specific energy load of a building is low, only 76 kilowatt hour per square meter per year. We applied the experience gained with the solar house. You remember for the solar house, we had 200 kilowatt hour per square meter, but at that level in 2009, these were the possibilities to reduce the energy consumption. In 2012, we succeeded to decrease the specific energy load to 77 kilowatt hour per square meter per year. From this energy, we cover 87% through several renewable energy systems. We have an important energy mix there with heat pumps, geothermal heat pumps with vertical and horizontal geothermal heat exchangers. Also on the rooftop of the buildings, we have solar thermal collectors with evacuated tube or flat plate to provide domestic hot water. We have photovoltaic platforms, as an example, on the rooftop of this building. We have a system with 12 kilowatt peak installed power, another 5 kilowatt on the rooftop of this building, and another 10 kilowatt on the green area around the building. Here we have an image with the laboratory with the heat pump, geothermal heat pump, extracting the energy from 90 meter depth boreholes, the storage tank for the thermal energy, and also the storage tank for solar thermal collectors installed on the rooftop. We installed different types of solar thermal collectors at different tilt angles to evaluate in the same condition, in the same time, the influence of the tilt angle in several periods of the year. So 9 of these 12 buildings are equipped with solar thermal collectors installed at different angles between vertical and horizontal position. The thermal energy provided is stored in a storage tank of 500 liters, and all the components are there. Here we have some results, experimental results obtained as an example for 2015-2016, related to the monthly energy demand of the laboratory building in terms of domestic hot water. Also, the thermal energy produced by such a solar thermal system installed on the laboratory rooftop. And finally, the solar fraction covered by this solar thermal system. When we discuss about the photovoltaic system installed in the institute, we also started from demonstrators, solar tracking demonstrators for individual photovoltaic modules. After that, we installed this solar tracking, this mechanism. You will see here it's a similar mechanism, but for a bigger array. So this platform is composed by 8 photovoltaic modules. So the installed power is about 2 kilowatt peak. And further on, we also extended this experience to strings of photovoltaic modules. Here you can see a photovoltaic string with 3 photovoltaic modules. So a capacity of 0.75 kilowatt peak. And here we have the system with 12 kilowatt peak installed power. Some experimental results also in the field of electricity produced by these photovoltaic modules. You will see here the electrical energy produced by this photovoltaic system in 2015 and 2016, and the coverage degree of the energy demand of that building. So it is visible like exactly like in the case of the thermal energy. During the summer, we approach 100% coverage degree. Also, in the institute, we have small wind turbines with installed power of 300 watts connected in one off-grid lighting system. We have some exterior lamps used to light the exterior parts of the institute. And here, beside the energy produced by this wind turbines, we also studied the influence of the building on the air flows, because you see we have installed these wind turbines in different parts of the roof to see what happens with the wind speed and direction. Well, concluding, we can say that our experience developed in the solar house, house in Brasov area provided with almost the entire energy from renewable energy sources. We can say that this is a really nearly zero energy building with 83% of energy covered from renewable energy. And we have already 11 years of functioning with a lot of monitoring systems. So we have experimental data that confirm this coverage. And this implemented system, the heat pump, solar thermal and photovoltaic modules are already paid back. With another words, the investitional costs are fully covered. This experience was used in the institute, Research and Development Institute of the Transylvania University of Brasov, where we already have more than 8 years of functioning since 2012. And this system, this mix, it's approaching the payback time. There we have a 98% of energy covered from renewable. More results you can find in this series of proceedings published in the Conference for Sustainable Energy organized by our research center each 3 years. And we invite you in 2023 to participate in this conference. We will send the invitation at that moment. Thank you for your attention, and I'm looking forward to answering to your questions.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Professor Moldovan, for this comprehensive.
I have a question.
Yes, please.
Yes, you comment about the nearly zero energy communities concept of the Braslow, yes. Transylvania, the very beginning. And we are also interested in this concept. Could you explain a little bit more about it?
So actually, it was the topic of our conference in 2017. If you send me an email, I can send you the paper related to this concept. The idea was, it is not enough to have individual buildings with renewable energy systems implemented on it. In our town in Brasov, there are a few buildings with renewable energy system, but it's not enough. So the municipality, the public administration should take measures to implement this kind of renewable energy system. Well, first, they have to decrease the energy consumption because there are several zones where they consume a lot of energy. So after they decrease the energy consumption, they must install this renewable energy system. And there are some initiatives in Brasov, and we are in well collaboration with the municipality, with the mayor, and with the local council. We have common projects. For example, we have students in the last year approaching this problem through the final bachelor or dissertation thesis. So the idea is to cover at least 50% of the energy demand of the community from renewable energy sources through systems implemented at the buildings level, but not necessary on the buildings. Imagine that we have in Brasov a very, let's say, nasty area, the former waste area where all the garbage was thrown. And now it's covered with a nice layer of green plants, but nobody can build something there. And one idea was to build their renewable energy system, photovoltaic, solar panel, because the electricity is not influenced but by what it's below. So in few words, this is the idea. Once again, if you send me an email, I can send you the paper.
Numele meu este Dorin Leț. Sunt cercetător științific în domeniul surselor regenerabile de energie și al automatizărilor. Permiteți-mi să vă invit la Universitatea Valahia din Târgoviște. Aceasta este situată în zona centrală a României, fostă capitală istorică în secolul XV, un oraș localizat geografic în zona subcarpatică, cu o populație de aproximativ 80.000 de locuitori.
Universitatea Valahia găzduiește peste 7.000 de studenți și are aproximativ 300 de angajați. Universitatea oferă 39 de specializări de licență, 42 programe de master și 6 direcții pentru studii doctorale. Studenții noștri își pot îmbunătăți cunoștințele și în cadrul Institutului de Cercetare al Universității, acolo unde aceștia sunt implicați în mod activ încă din faza studiilor de licență. Campusul nou construit se extinde pe o suprafață de 14.000 de metri pătrați. Aici funcționează 7 clădiri, altele 2 sunt în construcție și 6 vor fi construite în viitor. Clădirile educaționale sunt realizate cu o anvelopă eficientă energetic, iar clădirea Institutului de Cercetare a fost proiectată utilizând concepte pasive de tip Near Zero Energy Building. Printre direcțiile principale de cercetare abordate în cadrul Institutului ICSTM putem enumera surse regenerabile de energie, automatizări și eficientizare energetică în clădiri pasive. Institutul este un living laboratory și digital platform provider în cadrul programului ERANET Smart Energy Systems, precum și un site pilot într-un proiect Horizon 2020 Innovation Activities denumit eLand. În proiectul Estre Unica am prezentat o sumă de cazuri de bună practică exploatate de noi în cadrul Institutului de Cercetare ICSTM. Toate activitățile prezentate mai devreme în domeniul eficienței energetice se aplică în clădiri individuale, cu activități diferite, ceea ce înseamnă curbe de consum diferite. Pentru calcularea Smart Readiness Indicator, noi am propus ca studiu de caz clădirea Institutului de Cercetare, care este dotată cu mai multe instalații de producție din surse regenerabile de energie, respectiv fotovoltaic, eolian, termosolar, toate acestea cuplate cu stocare. Sistemul de climatizare HVAC este unul comun în clădirilor industriale. Acesta este compus din două boilere pe gaz natural, un chiller care funcționează și ca pompă de căldură, trei centrale de ventilație a câte 13.000 m3 pe oră și aproximativ 45 ventiloconvectori. ICSTM este o clădire cu 35 de laboratoare, dotată cu echipamente și instalații specifice activității de cercetare. Printre acestea putem enumera stația de producție aer comprimat, oxigen, azot și vacuum, instalația de neutralizare a apelor contaminate chimic, instalația de producție a apei ultrapure, precum și instalațiile de gaze tehnologice speciale. Clădirea integrează și instalații de producție a energiei din surse regenerabile, de tip fotovoltaic, eolian, termosolar, conectate cu elemente de stocare specifice. Sistemul electric este operat în regim microgrid și are capacitatea de a funcționa deconectat de la rețeaua națională. Toate instalațiile menționate anterior sunt interconectate într-un Building Automation and Control System sau BMS, care operează mai multe scenarii de eficientizare energetică, printre care controlul iluminatului și al climatizării pe bază de prezență, precum și operarea agregatelor termice în scenarii de tip Weather Compensation. Sistemul de Energy Management a fost de curând finalizat și integrează întregul campus al Universității Valahia. Acesta ne ajută în optimizarea mixului energetic de o manieră multivectorială, considerând și capacitățile de stocare.
During my presentation, I'm going to tackle the issue of carbon neutral university campuses. In the end, I hope you will identify best practice scenarios and that our efforts will inspire you to actively move towards a zero carbon economy. Valahia University of Târgoviște is young compared to other academia entities in Romania. In its 25 years of existence, our university is the only one building a campus site from scratch. This was a continuous struggle, which in 2018 brought all faculties from six separate locations to operate from inside the new campus site. Nowadays, the university has 10 faculties, seven of them operating in the new campus in two buildings. There are more than 10,000 students served by a dedicated 270 full-time teaching staff and 100 part-timers. Most of the students come from our county and neighboring ones. 28% of them are foreign students, and around 1,300 students are hosted in our dormitories on site. Our campus site, being one of the youngest university campuses in Romania, had the opportunity to implement newer technologies. The building's envelopes are energy efficient, glazing is specially treated, centralized heating and cooling using fan coils and other technologies are employed. This is the status of our campus site construction in 2009. The engineering faculty was under construction, the life sciences faculty as well, and only one of the student dormitories was operational, with two other under construction. In 2010, the ground basis for the university's research institute were set, financed from a new funding half of the 50 million euros being spent for the building and its specific installations, the other half being used for high-tech research equipment endowment. In 2016, the following buildings were operational: the engineering faculty, the research institute, and all three student dorm buildings. The EU-funded project ended, and with our first statement towards the sustainable and green campus, the institute building is powered by sun and wind. Research, development, and innovation activities in our university began in 1992, when the first R&D department at national level for energy and environment was created. The department conducted over 110 national and around 30 international projects in its first 10 years. The first Central European building integrated photovoltaic installation was developed by our team and was operational in 2002 with a 10 kilowatts peak power installed, and it was financed through an FP6 project. The Institute's building is fully operational from 2016, and it achieved its design capabilities from the point of view of energy efficiency and carbon footprint. Our open access data can be studied from publicly available PV systems on SMA Sunny portal page and from Victron Energy VRM World. During last 4 years of PV operation, we obtained over 150 tons CO2 reduction. Our institute's carbon footprint is further reduced by employing HVAC energy recovery in conjunction with the sophisticated building automation and control system. The system operates scenarios like load optimization, ambient temperature integral curve point set points, PID with time lock cascade forecasting, and PID interlock with predictive delivery temperatures. The system achieved 13% efficiency in gross electric energy consumption. The building was purposely constructed on the east-west axis for Bay PV sunshading installation. Facade photovoltaic modules were custom built to retain the same core aspect. Rooftop photovoltaics mixes three different material types. We installed three different rooftop small wind turbines and hybrid connection with the PV systems, and two 10 kilowatts peak power each at ground level on 20 meters high poles. The solar thermal installation is used as heat input for the HVAC-R and is also based on three different technologies. All installed RES has double role: research platform for different technologies and energy input. Building operations are connected to national grid with option to export electricity. Environmental monitoring is done for sun parameters, wind parameters, and air quality. Energy monitoring is employed over electric and thermal vectors. The PV installations are connected in various electrical schemes. PV1, it's a rooftop on-grid installation. PV2, it's a building integrated photovoltaic sunshading storage based hybrid wind system. PV3, it's a Bay PV curtain self-consumption system. PV4, the sunshading microgrid operation covering essential loads and the entire IT infrastructure. And PV5, it's a sunshading off-grid system for the solar thermal installation power needs. In this schematic, you can observe the local energy system less PV interconnections. The wind turbines are used in two mounting positions, rooftop and ground-based. WT1 is located at 24 meters altitude from Earth with a horizontal 10 kilowatts rotor. WT2 is mounted at 18 meters height with a vertical axis 10 kilowatt turbine. For the rooftop installations, WT3, we have two turbines of 1 kilowatt horizontal and vertical axis and one 3 kilowatts hybrid Darius Avonius with magnetic levitation mounting. In this schematic, you can observe the less wind turbines interconnections. The solar thermal installation consists in three independent hydraulic systems. ST1, it's comprised of flat plate collectors. ST2, heat pipe collectors. ST3, it's a mix of the previous. Storage in 3000 liter buffers is located in the basement, where two absorption chillers convert hot into cold water for summertime HVAC cooling regime. This schematic, you can observe how the solar thermal installation interconnects with the HVACR building system. All described infrastructure is going to be piloted in the framework of the Horizon 2020 ELAND project, which my colleague Heidi Tuiskolan had previously presented. The project aims at decarbonizing energy Icelands with the use of a special toolbox set. Along with the technical use cases, stakeholders engagement and business cases, which are being actively developed. All project goals are going to be demonstrated in three pilot sites. They have different geography, demography, sociography, and maturity in terms of community and end user activities. Implementation of different energy vectors, including storage, amount of renewables in the local energy mix, and variety of loads that call for an efficient and an intelligent management system. In our pilot site, the first use case that is going to be tested is called the integration of multi-vector LES management in the EMS. For one office building, two faculty buildings, the research institute, and three student dormitory buildings. The system will allow future developments as well. On-site constructions are ongoing for one new faculty building, EV research facility, a 500 seats amphitheater, and two more student dormitory buildings. The Research Institute REST infrastructure is going to be used for multi-site vector simulations. A second use case scenario, optimization of operation for LES, is going to be tested between all three local power transformers and the existing loads. Some other scenarios are going to be tested as well in the Research Institute's buildings, such as shift building loads using demand side management, optimal scheduling of thermal and electrical storage, and storing excess generation in the thermal network. So what's after? ELAND represents our first step into better defining a strategy and action plan towards a carbon neutral campus. In our ongoing design, in the first place, we want to take advantage from the 500 meters of proximity to Yalomitsa River, considering a micro hydro with storage. In the second phase, a district heating and cooling network is going to help optimize the campus building internal environment for a healthy and comfortable place. This DAC is going to be supported by heat pumps. For us to surpass sustainability levels and become an active energy Iceland, we are going to employ concentrated photovoltaic trackers for electricity export to other energy Icelands and the grid. This concludes my presentation. I hope you will revisit the recording and get inspired in your own projects.
Bună ziua, Andrei Ceclan mă numesc, fac parte din Centrul de Cercetare în Tranziție Energetică, Energy Transition Research Center, din cadrul Universității Tehnice, centru coordonat de către profesorul Dan Micu, în contextul în care suntem implicați ca suporterei proiectului S3 Unica, ne-am propus să facem o scurtă trecere în revistă a ce se întâmplă în Universitatea Tehnică din Cluj-Napoca la nivel de angajament privind reducerea emisiilor de CO2 asociate cu consumul de energie și transformarea clădirilor. Și aici, pe de o parte, în primul rând avem angajamentul ferm și suportul întreg al conducerii universității în acest demers prin faptul că s-au alocat resurse importante pentru renovarea campusurilor universitare ale universității, pentru pregătirea unui roadmap, unei foi de parcurs privind reducerea emisiilor de CO2 pentru început până în anul 2030 și apoi o decarbonare totală până în anul 2050, aliniat cu ce de fapt se întâmplă la nivelul întregii Europe. Și pe de altă parte, prin faptul că acest centru de cercetare și de sprijinire a tranziției energetice și în România și la nivel internațional derulează în prezent o serie de proiecte internaționale în parteneriat cu universități din Europa și cu companii private din Europa pe mai multe subiecte. Unul dintre ele constă în demonstrarea funcționalității unor tehnologii cu surse regenerabile de energie pe complexul de natație al Universității Tehnice, unde ne pregătim să instalăm o centrală de cogenerare, o turbină axială eoliană și un pachet de panouri fotovoltaice din sticlă transparente, încadrate în conceptul Building Integrated Photovoltaics, pe care le vom gestiona printr-un software de management energetic care va avea înglobați algoritmi de inteligență artificială. Acesta este un proiect pilot demonstrativ, așa cum anterior, pe 12 dintre clădirile Universității Tehnice, am instalat un sistem de monitorizare energetică și control a sistemelor tehnice cu scopul de a demonstra, și am făcut asta cu succes, serviciul de demand response pentru consumatori. Iată un alt proiect pilot demonstrativ pe care ulterior l-am tratat printr-un alt proiect, Orizont 2020, intitulat eDream, prin care am arătat posibilitatea de replicare a serviciului demand response la nivel de consumatori rezidențiali. Deci am ieșit din curtea universității la nivel de consumatori. Apoi, întorcându-ne la obiectivul de decarbonare, dincolo de resursele consistente pe care conducerea universității le alocă pentru transformarea și renovarea aprofundată a clădirilor, cu scopul principal de a crește confortul și starea de bine a studenților, a profesorilor, a personalului administrativ în clădiri și de a crește performanța energetică a acestor clădiri, avem un alt proiect finanțat cu un grant norvegian de instalarea unei centrale fotovoltaice care să asigure parțial consumul unuia dintre campusurile universității. Și este un pas înainte în ceea ce înseamnă introducerea de surse regenerabile și decarbonarea. Iar la nivel didactic, prin proiectele pe care le derulăm, SME Power Efficiency Gear to SME, sprijinim companiile mici și mijlocii din România și profesioniștii prin profesionalizare, prin faptul că îi invităm în prezent online și sperăm cât de curând și fizic să participe la cursuri de informare și de formare pe teme ce țin de eficiență energetică și sustenabilitate. Practic, formăm manageri energetici pentru companii, manageri energetici pentru orașe și specialiști în proiectarea și realizarea de clădiri cu consum energetic aproape egal cu zero, NZEB. Și faptul că avem toate aceste inițiative și proiecte în curs de implementare în universitate ne-a atras și implicarea în proiectul S3 Unica, unde avem posibilitatea să schimbăm experiențe atât cu universități, cu alte universități din România, și este cazul unui contact activ cu Universitatea Valahia din Târgoviște, cât și cu universitățile partenere din acest proiect S3 Unica din celelalte țări ale Uniunii Europene. Așa încât împreună am ajuns să lucrăm prin acest centru de cercetare în tranziție energetică la o foaie de parcurs și la o strategie de decarbonare a campusurilor universitare. Nu numai al Universității Tehnice, ci încercăm să facem o replicare și pentru celelalte campusuri universitare din România și chiar să trecem la o colaborare activă pe zona de management energetic urban cu primăriile, cu autoritățile publice locale care dețin și ele fonduri importante de clădiri publice și campusuri de clădiri. Cam acestea sunt detaliile pe care le-am gândit. Mulțumim!
Thank you. So all in all, I think you have saw the presentation I've prepared. It's about the Energy Transition Research Center in Technical University of Cluj-Napoca and the projects we had or we have at this moment related to energy efficiency, energy management, including in the university campus. What I want to say is that within this project conducted in Romania by ALEA, Astra Unica, we had a very good occasion to get to know each other, the universities from Romania, to see what are our infrastructures in terms of renewables, in terms of different equipments dedicated to research or to prove the best available techniques in increasing the energy performance of the buildings. So this was one very good occasion to get to know each other with the colleagues from Brașov, from Târgoviște, from Bacău, from Alba Iulia, and also to start and work together to potential project proposals. And starting from this point, I would say that our center, together with our colleagues from the other universities you have saw, are very open to get to in touch with you along with ALEA and prepare other proposals, project proposals on Horizon Europe, on LIFE, on the other course that will be available in the next period. So we have these projects, one of them called Dr. Bob, in which we implemented building energy management system in 12 out of the 35 public buildings belonging to the TUCN campus. And we applied different scenarios of demand response in these buildings at an aggregated level, because looking at the whole campus and only at this level of the 12 buildings, the total energy use and the electrical power which is absorbed, it's comparable with a medium-sized industrial site. Then we continued this Dr. Bob approach on another project called eDream. I think it's available here, yeah, on which this demand response, along with our colleagues from the Automation and Computer Science Department, we proposed to be applied on the residential users using the blockchain technology. And this project also ended some weeks ago. Then we are now in the phase of the implementation of some renewable energy technologies within this project called Renewable Cogeneration and Storage Technologies Integration for Energy Autonomous Buildings, Recognition, and I will get to it. And in this case also, we have a demo pilot site, because in almost all the projects we were focused on having demo pilot sites using the very buildings of the campus, of the TUCN campus. So we will install, as it was presented also in the video material, a small scale CHP unit, building integrated photovoltaic panels, an actual wind turbine, and EV chargers. And then we'll test them integrated in the buildings, in the swimming pool of the TUCN campus, using an artificial intelligence algorithm for the energy management of the building.
Beside the project in which we are directly involved as partners or coordinator, we are also involved in several other projects as a third part, as subcontracted part. And one of these is Reflow project belonging to the Cluj-Napoca City Municipality, on which we prepared the roadmap for the implementation of several categories of solutions for greening the city and for a circular economy, for a more circular economy. And here we also have a demo pilot, the student hostel belonging to a high school. Then in Alba Iulia, from where Alea is, we were involved together with the Alba Iulia City Municipality in their project called City Exchange in the preparation of a feasibility approach for a high school also, for Dorin Pavel High School, to become a positive energy campus. Because at that site, in that site, they have an installed photovoltaic capacity which exceeds the energy use of the campus after performing some optimizations, both in the electricity and in thermal loads. Our colleagues, getting back to the university, from the Distributed System Research Laboratory, Professor Tudor Chora, are also involved in this ongoing project called P2P Flexibility Marketplace and Energy Communities, a very interesting subject, in fact, Energy Communities, the project acronym is BRIGHT, in which they are trying to promote, to develop and promote a package of distributed energy services to an energy community here in Romania. Then, beside the technology and demo sites implementation projects, which are on the innovation and research and innovation calls, we are also involved in some dissemination projects. One of them is called SMIM Power, which approaches the SMEs from Romania, in our case, and which consists in delivering trainings and energy analysis instruments for the SMEs so that these companies, which have relevant energy use, not any type of SME, to be able to handle their energy management, to be able to handle their energy use, and in the recent period also the local energy generation. And this is of very high interest at this moment due to the context of the energy prices increase in Romania and also in Europe, and to the very, very poor energy security which we are facing in Romania. Gear to SME, it's another project connected with SMIM Power, on which we are focusing also on SMEs as a university to deliver trainings and professional capacity to the SMEs which are located in industrial parks. So we have a clear focus here on the industrial parks. And beside these Horizon projects, some of them already implemented, other ongoing, we also have an infrastructure project, a small scale one, in fact, 160 kilowatts peak photovoltaic plant to be installed. It's under installation using the support of the Norway grants. And this will cover about 12% out of the total electricity use of the QCN campus, which is a high amount, in fact. Then, at the university level, the rector contracted a loan from the European Investment Bank through the Romania Higher Education Program loan to start a deep renovation of all the buildings which are not at this moment renovated, and to install infrastructure, laboratory infrastructure in them, consisting in this amount, which represents about 30% out of the total investment amount which the university is prepared to develop in the next few years. Our involvement as a research center in this project was to prepare the roadmap for the university for the decarbonation on the one side, and on the other side to prepare the design teams and the requirements for the buildings to be renovated. And this is very important because someone has to establish what is the aim, what is the energy performance we want to reach, and so on. And for the actions and results we have accomplished up to this moment, together with the city municipality, which is a strong partner for us, for the university, Cluj City Municipality, we were awarded in Brussels 2 years ago and in the United States 3 years ago with this Energy Management Awards. And in the end, what I want to highlight as I started is that we are prepared to get involved in future project proposals using our infrastructure, using our knowledge and competencies in other projects, including in projects aiming university campuses. And along with our colleagues from the other universities, from Târgoviște, from Brașov, from Bacău, from Alba Iulia. So this is it. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor, for this impressive package of collaboration examples that you have been taking on. Yes, basically, we have reached now the end of the presentation sessions session of this event. Hopefully, we managed to show the participants some of the initiatives the Romanian universities are undertaking.
Okay. Hi, my name is Constantin Puțanu. I am a lecturer at the Faculty of Exact Science and Engineering from the 1st December 1980 University from Alba Iulia, Romania. I'm sorry, but I don't have a webcam, so I can make myself visible as an image. I especially thank you to Mr. Andonescu for the invitation to participate today in the event organized by you. The university I belong is neither a partner not a collaborator in this project yet. I believe that the engineering specialization with priority the environmental engineering specialization and the applied electronic specialization from the 1st December 1918 University from Alba Iulia can have important involvement in the project S3 Unica. We have a few expert teachers in the field of green energy implementation who are very interested in collaborating with the organization involved in the project to promote and implement such policies. Since a few years ago, academic research teams within the aforementioned specialization belonging to the Faculty of the Exact Science and Engineering have been concerned to get involved nationally and internationally in program aims at reducing carbon emissions. In line with this concern, the academic teams of the scientific research recently at the University of Alba Iulia, certain policies is reducing carbon emission have been implemented in this educational structure. Obviously, due to the limited budget available to the University of Alba Iulia, specific to small to medium-sized university, the investment were materialized through the following infrastructure improvements. The first improvements consist of replacing of interior luminaires using manually operated incandescent bulb with the luminaires equipped with presence sensors and LED bulbs. And the second improvement consists in the replacement of the classical taps from the water supply installation with the structure provide with proximity sensor for hands. These two infrastructure change have had the effect in addition to reducing cost of an indirect contribution to reducing the carbon emission by the energy saving at the providers of this public utilities. Unfortunately, because immediately after the structural change were made, the pandemic period began and the student did not physically come to the university, I do not think the registered energy saving can be relevant. No. Like new investment plans for the near future in my university, the management of the University of Alba Iulia plans to modernize all the equipment that work in the university canteen. In concluding my presentation, I can say that I really want that through that these policies, practices by the University of Alba Iulia, this academic institution can be included as a partner or a collaborator in the structure of the association you represent.
Well, thank you to all participants for your patience, to our partners for a very interesting presentation, and we remain for the future together to finalize what we start in this very interesting project. Thank you a lot and see you with the next meeting in the framework of S3 Unica or other. Please, Alessia, last word from your part as coordinator. Please, Alessia, sorry.
Yes, thank you very much indeed to all of you. Really, you did a great effort and the presentations were very concrete. And the videos are really impressive. So the level is very high, as always, as in the previous exchange of experience. And so thank you to the professors for and all the members of the universities, in Romanian universities involved. Really, you are a great team and very well coordinated by Florin and Tiberiu. I had no doubt about it. And so really, thank you indeed. We have a more concrete approach now to the solutions you are. And Zebed, I don't know how to pronounce, never, I don't manage. Zeb buildings. And so now keep on working on action plans, please, in synergy between project partners and stakeholders. Otherwise, we don't manage to have the good to reach the goal of the action plans by April of next year, but before already the mid, as we said before, the middle of January. Thank you very much indeed.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.